I just wanted to talk to you guys a little bit about having belief versus like a willingness to claim that you have belief.
Okay.
When maybe you don't. And I kind of just want to hear you guys talk about it a little bit. But I do notice that when I go to church, that it seems like there are a lot of people that I would classify as not necessarily having belief, but just like having a willingness to claim that they have belief. Mm-hmm. And this is really kind of puzzling to me. And I don't quite understand it. And I just, sometimes I think maybe they're trying to like use that willingness to claim it, hoping to like grow to have belief. But I don't know if that's even possible, or I don't quite understand it. And I don't even know if that's the truth of the situation, but I was just wanting to hear you guys talk about, you know, people who like do have belief versus people who kind of maybe go and put themselves in that community, but don't have it, but like just have a willingness to claim that they have it. Or yeah, I don't quite know, but I remember what I'm trying to get to.
Just the old like phrase, you know, fake it till you make it type of things. And I mean, some people do employ that method, but there's a lot of, just off the top of my head, reasons that I can see someone that doesn't necessarily have that belief, but that will outwardly, you know, do actions or try to claim that belief. Because sometimes it's just about belonging. Right. Depending on your community, how, if it's a small town, let's say, and everybody goes to this particular church, and you may not necessarily be a believer, but you don't want to put that information out there. So even though you're not, you go there and you do all the motions as if you're a believer, just to fit in, just to have that community, to be normal and accepted within that framework. And it would seem strange, like if you don't understand how that might go. But there's people that are in church, you know, maybe pastors that don't believe, but they have to go through those motions because, you know, maybe that's their livelihood. And if someone knew, maybe they might lose their livelihood all of a sudden and not have really any safety net there to catch them. And so there's a lot of different reasons that are there. In my circle, it was more about, I mean, in my mind, there are some other people that I know that are non-believers, but you would never hear them say it. Mm-hmm. You know, you would never see them post on Facebook about it because they are afraid that someone in the family might find out. And it'll get back to, you know, grandmama or something like that. And
don't want to hurt the people that they care about that are in their family.
Right. Don't want to lose them.
Yeah. Because the loss of family connections is a real threat for some people for disclosing that they are atheists. So that's a big thing. The other thing is, there are people sitting in the pews who will actually threaten your life if they find out you're an atheist. And I mean, that's a...
Or your profession, like just being a plumber or an electrician, like, you know, having a trade, or you know, you're an AC repair individual, and if that gets out, then people may not, you know, take your business. Or a lawyer, you know, it can have a lot of implications that are there. And so there's a wide variety of reasons that people would claim it, even if they didn't believe it at all, even if they found it repugnant. You know, it may be more convenient, make more safe for them. Just depends on that situation, really.
That's probably true. And I kind of meant it more in like the, like an internal and a personal way. I get the cultural or social reasons, but I was kind of thinking more like on the internal of what that person actually thinks or believes, or like what their motivation is with doing that. But I understand what you're talking about with like the, you know, the social stuff. I totally get that.
Yeah. But, and I mean, a lot of it too is that if they were raised in a religion and they've been indoctrinated, particularly with, you know, the doctrine of hell, they may not actually believe, but they may be afraid to just come right out and say that. Because they've been indoctrinated with that fear. We talk to atheists all the time on this show and in email who, they're definitely atheists, but they wake up every day in fear that they've made a mistake and they're gonna go to hell. And it takes sometimes years for people to get past that and to come to terms with the fact that this was something that was told to them when they were very young, and it's not true. This is not going to happen to them. But, you know, when you plant that fear into someone so young, it's hard to shake that.
Yeah. And it's also, it could be, you know, not necessarily about the fitting in portion, but they may have been raised to think that this is the right thing to do.
Yeah.
And so even though they're a non-believer, they're looking at this is the right thing, this is what everyone around them has right. been doing, and this is the way I should be. And, you know, fake it till you make it, you know, trying to put that face on, and hopefully one day you'll actually believe it the way that you used to, or that the way that you think other people around you believe. And so it could be as simple as that as well. But, you know, it's hard to get into that, into the frame of mind of someone, and that it's just, there's so much variability in the reasons that people make that decision to just kind of claim it without actually being within, being a holder of that belief.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Well, that's, you know, basically all I want to talk to you guys about. So thanks for having my call.
Okay. Well, thanks for calling.
Yeah. Thank you.
Yeah, that's interesting about, you know, what motivates people to stay in religious communities even after they don't believe anymore. And a lot of times it does come down to some kind of social connection or community tie that keeps people there, or family ties are really important. And there's some religious communities that if you come out as an atheist, like if you're in a Unitarian congregation and you say you're an atheist, you know, half the people are probably going to say, yeah, us too.
Yeah.
And it's no big deal, you know.
While others are,
yeah,
you would just never hear the end of it. It could be horrific. You know, whether it's, you know, it's just, there's so much that's out there. So yeah, it's
And I mean,
hard to imagine at all.
I know a lot of Jewish people who are just fairly open about the fact they don't actually believe in a God. But they maintain ties with their synagogue because for them that's about culture and family and tradition. And so that is the most important thing for them. It's not, and nobody in the congregation even cares that they don't believe in a God. They actually have lively discussions about this, you know, and it's not a big deal. So, you know, it is possible to maintain ties to a religious community as a non-believer and still, you know, get something out of that.
Sure, sure.